You know, a lot of reactions would come in on what to expect in this budget. 5th July is when the budget is. So I think that's going to be, the key event now that Street would watch out for. My colleague caught up with Feedback Infra's Vinayak Chatterjee on what to expect in terms of infrastructure space in this budget.
I think it is also clear that the government will find ways and means within the budget to keep pumping into public expenditure, because it is also the main pump primer for growth and employment. So I think there will be a balancing act on 5th July. But more importantly, as you would have heard Minister Gadkari speaking a little while ago to the CII gathering, the government and particularly the infrastructure ministries are also looking at two things. They are looking at diversifying or raising capital outside the conventional sources by looking at developmental financial institutions, pension funds, etc., so as to reduce the dependence on budgetary outlays. And this time, Mr. Gadkari has said, slightly different to his last term, that he is going to engage more deeply with the private sector across all the areas where private capital can come in. And I think it's not just for the highway sector, but sector after sector in infra are going to do two things. Obviously, there'll be a huge dependence on the union budget, but they're going to look at alternative sources of developmental finance, and they're going to engage more deeper with private capital.
How ready is the private sector? Because we have seen private sector has been keeping their purse strings pretty tight in the last couple of years. Money coming in from private sector hasn't really happened.
So there are issues there. For example, if you see the financial closure of hybrid annuity in roads, private sector capital has come in. Yeah. The real issue is, and this is something that you would have heard me talk about with the minister. So the historically, the model concessional agreements, not just in the road sector, but across many sectors, have clearly been seen to be rather one-sided. Mm-hmm. The risks allocation between public and private sector are not properly done. And we and CII today have asked to be engaged to review the whole risk allocation matrix. And I think if a fresh look is taken and model and concession agreements are structured, which substantively address the risk that the private sector can bear and cannot bear, I think financing would become much, much easier.
Would you say that the cost of capital also is very high, and that is one of the reasons that private sectors are kind of keeping their hands away from investing majorly into infra projects?
You know, I'm one of those people who believe that in 30, 60 year concession periods, the cost of capital is important, but that is not the only driver. For example, the cost of capital wasn't particularly lower in the period 2007 to 2012, when you saw a huge burst of private investment in highways, airports, etc. So cost of capital is important, but in my view, more important is the structure and nature and the friendliness and the risk allocation of the concession agreements.
In the meeting today, the council meeting today, there's also been a talk about how there is a lack of trust between the government and the industry. What do you expect the government to do? How can we expect that trust deficit to be bridged?
Look, the trust, Mr. Gadkari also pointed out that it is not maybe true that we use a broad brush to talk about the trust deficit across industry. There may be particular sectors that are hurting more than others. And he basically said that there's no fundamental belief, or there's nobody out to create a trust deficit.